Hey all! I'm excited to share with you the new features we will be using in V-Ray 6. Anyone can go to the Chaos website and join the beta program in order to test this new version before it gets released on July. The first feature we will see is called V-Ray and Mesh. If I try to explain what it does with words, you will get confused, so let's see directly using an example. I have this partition which has a solid surface here, and let me hit the render button. This is what we get. Now let's say that I want the fill of this partition to be a mesh having this pattern. To do that, we will use the V-Ray and Mesh modifier. I will select the surface I want to transform. I will click on the modifier list and choose V-Ray and Mesh modifier. I will go to the Objects rollout, click on the Add button and choose my pattern. Let's render. It's really cool, isn't it? Now, if from this geometry I only want part of it, I will use the crop box size values. So now I will ask to repeat only this part. That's really awesome. And I can play with the tiling to adjust its density. I'm sure this modifier will come in handy to all of you. Another new feature in V-Ray 6 is the procedural clouds. I have this scene that simply has a ground and I have placed the V-Ray sun with the default V-Ray sky. If I press render, here is the result we get. It's quite bright, so let me adjust the sun intensity. That's better. So now, in V-Ray 6, in the V-Ray Sun parameters, a new rollout is added, the clouds. Simply enable the clouds on checkbox. If we now render, some really beautiful clouds are added to our sky. If we make the density 1, you can see how denser they become. While if we make it 0.1, you can see some small clouds here. This is such a beautiful new feature. Finally, one really cool new feature is Chaos Scatter. It allows us to distribute objects randomly on a surface. So, let's say that I want to fill my ground with grass. The simplest way to do that is to open the Chaos Cosmos browser. Go to 3D Models, to Presets, and download one of the two types. Simply drag it on the ground, and it automatically distributes the grass on the surface. Let's do a test render. See how beautiful it looks? And with no effort at all, it was a simple drag and drop. Instead of using the presets, we can choose to distribute any object that we want. Let's go to the Cosmos browser, to 3D Models, Vegetation, and Trees. And let me choose these two types and drag them here. Let's click on the Create Chaos Scatter button, click and drag over here. Go to the Modify tab In the Objects rollout, I will click on this plus icon and click on the ground. I just selected where I want the trees to distribute on. And now I will click on this plus icon and click on the two trees. You can see that they automatically distribute on the ground. Let's do a test render. So you can see that it randomly scatters both trees, giving a variation to the final result. You can add as many tree types as you'd like. Now, if you see the scattered objects, they follow the inclination of the ground, so they look like they are bending. To avoid that, go to the scatter parameters and to the steeping angle. If you make the normal versus Z 1 instead of 0, then all objects will face upwards. You can already see it from the preview. To control the density of the distribution, we will go to the count value in the surface scattering rollout. Count 1000 means that 1000 trees will be placed. If I double it, I double the density. While if, let's say, I make this 10, you can now see only 10 trees scattered on the ground. We can do a ton of things with Chaos Scatter, so I will prepare a new video just for this feature. Basically, these three are the new features in V-Ray 6, and apart from those, we have improvements on past features, like, for instance, that you can now use V-Ray Decal to add displacement to any surface, or we have new and improved materials. But this is it for now, and I will come back with another video as I'll be testing V-Ray 6 further before its release. Thanks for watching. I will see you all in my next video.